Charlie Loughman.
Rosie Loxton.
Team Rosie and Charlie, CrossFit Hereford, Battle of the Gods, 15.1.
Quick run through a kit.
15 kilo bar,
2.5, same on the other side. 3 5-kilo discs. 3 5-kilo discs. Men's bar,
20 kilo bar, 10 kilos either side. 4 sets of 5. 4 sets of 5.
1-inch box, timer, judge.
Try to keep you close to me, but I got in between. Tried to square, not be in there, but said that I should have been. Hold back the river, let me look in your eyes. Hold back the river so wide. Stop for a minute and see where you hide. Hold back the river, hold back.
Appearances. He was on Sunday brunch earlier, probably chopping things. They always get people to just chop things. And Jonathan Ross yesterday evening on ITV on the last show of the series. That is James Bay and Hold Back the River at number 3. Hello, Pete and Tom in Devon. Really want Ed Sheeran to be number 1 tonight. They are driving home from a freezing winter surf. Also, Will, who say the chart is easing the pain of a marathon drive from Glasgow back to London tonight. And Jake is about to go and have a massive roast with the family. Okay, here's where we find out who has the UK's official number one this week. A week ago, Jess Glynn had her first solo number one with Hold My Hand, although obviously she's featured on the number one single with Clean Bandit, Rather Be, and also on the number one hit from Route 94, My Love. But her first solo number one with Hold My Hand. But on Wednesday's official chart update, Ed Sheeran went straight in with Bloodstream. So who is it? Jess Glynn or Ed Sheeran at number one? I can tell you now that Ed Sheeran and Rudimental are number two, which means Jess Glynn's done it again. Clara caught up with Ed recently.
Who's this boy? He's a ping-a-ling. Are you happy being introduced to Ping-a-ling, Ed Sheeran?
Yes.
Welcome back to Radio 1. I say welcome back. You may as well have an official BBC pass now. I've been pretty much here, like, all the time.
I do a show.
If you want. What kind of show would you do?
What I do is probably what I do in real life, is when I find a song, just play it over and over and over and over and over and over. So my show for 3 hours would just be the new song that I like.
Fair enough. At the moment, what song is that?
What was there? There was a song that I quite liked. But I do the sixth room, that one.
Okay, I know what you're talking about. Okay. We've got to talk about Bloodstream, obviously. Now a remix with an extra bit of that rudimentary. Just work for those guys, because I've seen them out kind of socially and how they just are just in general. So I'm just trying to make them like, is it that same kind of crazy mania, or are they like really focused and really serious?
They're all on it. They're all very talented.
So I have to talk to you about the success of Multiply, because every week since I've done the chart, it literally has just not left the top five album chart. You've got about 14 months, which will not leave the top 14. Not the way from playing, it's a great thing. How does it feel just to keep, you know, enjoying the success of that album?
I can't complain. I think the public will complain eventually.
Well, they're not complaining, they're still buying it.
Yeah, but no, I think it'd be smart for me to take some time off. You don't want to overkill it.
Well, look, in May, you are going to be heading across America for a massive North American tour. What's your favourite eating state in America? I'm going to Louisiana, which I'm really jealous about.
Do you know what? I find the big meal to you feel like you've been abused by food after you've eaten. You just kind of want to wrap yourself in a blanket and like recover.
Fair dues. What's your favourite dessert?
I do like apple crumble.
Homemade?
Yeah.
You've
been
a baker?
It depends, but my mum's making it, then maybe not.
Hang on, what? So your mum's apple crumble isn't like all that?
No, it is, before it goes in the oven. And then our oven, like,
I'm so intrigued.
I've offered. Like, my mum's kitchen is just not saying a lot. And I've offered, I'm like, look, I will buy you a new oven. I bought her a kettle and I plugged it in, and then I went back and she had the old kettle and put the other kettle elsewhere. So I think just you don't touch your mum's kitchen, but the oven doesn't work and it just burns the bottom of it. So
I see.
You have a pizza and it looks perfect on top and it's rock solid on the bottom.
Delicious. Well,
thanks
to Mama Sharon for at least keeping it real and not accepting a new fancy kitchen off you.
Yeah, no, but that's been like since we moved to the house.
I like the sound of your mum.
She's cool.
She sounds like she's delightfully, like, not, like, kind of into you as being Ed Sheeran, the pop star.
She's
just...
Oh, no, she's definitely not. She's definitely not, yeah.
But your dad, on the other hand, is, like, your hip-hop roadie.
He's delightfully unhappy. He's passionate about what I'm passionate about, which is music. And, he just gets the that I'm into. And then it ends up meeting, and, you know, Dot Rock with me before I released my second album. And like, just kind of thing, a big nasty gigs, hung out with my dad.
Amazing.
Actually, the first time I was with dad, that's the, like, before, how are you? It's like, oh, how's Papa Sheeran?
So do you actually just want to meet your dad? He's cool. Okay.
He's cool, yeah.
Tell him to holler next time.
I'm impressed because he's able to get into anywhere. I'll be ringing him and be like, where is he? And then I'll just turn up.
It's been a hoot, Ed Sheeran.
Pleasure.
Thanks very much.
Hi, I'm Ed Sheeran. This is Blood.
Two. I've been spending enough time. Couple women by my side. I've been spending enough time. Sipping on red wine. I've been sitting every age. Picking up pages. How'd I get so faded? If you love me, never learn.
Broken heart with love.